Yo, what's up, y'all? This your boy Raw coming at you raw. Hope your day is all well and bless you for stopping by. Look, if y'all saw us on Gaming Talk yesterday, we do Gaming Talk every week on Thursday, 5 p.m. U.S. Central Time, and we stream it on the gamingfordays.raw YouTube channel. Put it on iTunes, Stitcher Radio, and also SoundCloud. And in that video, or at least in that stream, in that recording, the Real Maslin, in front of the show, Gaming Talk crew member, he asked me, is PS4 Pro a failure? And this was in response of my video talking about if Scorpio, that's Project Scorpio, the next Xbox from Microsoft, if that with its own game, don't run it in 60 frames per second, it'll be a failure personally to me. It was in response of that video, me saying that. He said, is PS4 Pro a failure? Because it don't run games, all games in 60 frames. Now, PS4 Pro do run games in 60 frames per second, but not every single game. Not, especially not their exclusives. Now, there is one exclusive that they do run at 60, that's Nioh. Nier Automata is not a Sony exclusive, nor is it a PS4 exclusive, but it is definitely on the console and it runs at higher frame rates than 30. Uncharted 4 has a 60 FPS mode only on multiplayer and not in single player. And then obviously you have new games, Dad of War, aka God of War, and Days Gone, and also Death Stranding and Spider-Man all coming out, which I highly doubt they will run at 60. But anyway, his question to me was, is the PS4 Pro a failure because it doesn't run everything at 60? And I said, and I concluded with a yes, because I paired it up with the PS4 Pro conference last year. I went back and watched the whole reveal conference all over again and concluded that PS4 Pro isn't. It is exactly what Sony said it'll be. Andrew House and Mark Sony, they were, and I might be saying his last name wrong, but they both were on stage talking about PS4 Pro with all their partners, third-party developers and stuff like that. And I said, based off what they said there, PS4 Pro is a failure. Because in my head, I thought they were saying 4K, 4K, 4K in that press conference. And they was saying 4K, 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 but not once did they say the PS4 Pro will have native 4K gaming or true 4K gaming. And that's literally the words coming out of Phil Spencer's mouth on the Xbox stage. See, in that sense, the PS4 Pro isn't a failure. So in Sony's eyes, or at least they covered a butt in saying this, they said the PS4 Pro will support, and this is three quotes you can hone in on. I'm going to just say it. And in that press conference, I watched the video at 5 minutes and 40 seconds around that time. They say PS4 Pro will be the number one provider of high resolutions and HDR content, which it is. That's a fact. PS4 Pro is the number one provider of high resolution and HDR content when it comes to gaming on console. And then the 7 minute around that time gate, they say PS4 Pro is not intended to blur the lines between console generations. That was kind of a pot shot at Microsoft saying that Scorpio is basically that, right? It's blurring the lines between console generations. They say in the PS4 Pro reveal conference, its goal is to take the PS4 experience to a whole new level. So right out the gate, they said, this is not a next-gen console. Right out the gate, they said, this is not supposed to blur PS5 or whatever. This is to make the PS4 experience better. That's what they said at the 7 minute marker. And then at the 7:30 minute marker around that time, they say PS4 Pro will be able to reach higher resolutions for console gaming in 2016. And of course, this was 2016 when they did this press conference. And still to this day, console gaming relies on Pro to support or give high resolution gaming. A lot of third party games and first party games are higher resolutions as far as consoles on the PS4 Pro. And yeah, you know, off those three things they said in the conference, PS4 Pro is not a failure. Because it does all three of those things. Not once did they say PS4 Pro will be a native 4K console. And they said at the end, it's up to the gamers to choose. So if you bought a PS4 Pro and you're mad at it, that's your fault because you didn't understand what they were saying. I say this about PS4 It's not a PS4 Pro. It's not a 4K console. Like, I'm talking about straight up everything 4K. But the reason why you should forgive it in not being that, because it has exclusives. It plays PS4 exclusives in the best way. All of PS4 exclusives are better on it. It's the only way you can play Horizon Zero Dawn at higher resolutions, as well as stable frame rates in more demanding scenes of the game, as well as The Last of Us Remastered, highest resolutions and a better frame rate stability in demanding parts of the game, as well as games like Nioh, as well as games like Gravity Rush, as well as games... Look, the list keeps on going, and it's going to reach all the way to 2020 with games like Death Stranding taking advantage of the PS4 Pro, will take advantage of the PS4 Pro, Days Gone, Spider-Man, PS4. Like, the PS4 Pro is a better PS4, and that's what Sony was saying out the gate when it was revealed last year in 2016. This is 2017. But anyway, look, PS4 Pro, answer that question. Is it a failure? Is PS4 Pro a failure? You could say kinda, but it kinda isn't either, because of the fact that it is exactly what Sony said it'll be at the reveal. See, Scorpio, in comparison, they said it's gonna be a true 4K machine. If Scorpio has more games that are not running in 4K, like if there's more games that are not running in 4K, I would consider that being a failure, like straight up. And if it has more 4K games than non-4K games, then I'll consider that a success story for the Scorpio. But like I said in the beginning about the whole 60 thing, the reason why my expectation is so high for Scorpio is because we had a whole year to sit on it. If the thing got announced and then 3 months or 4 months later it got released, I probably wouldn't be like this. But the fact that I am, is it is what it is. Like, Scorpio has been hyped to the roof and it's still not out. It's going to be a whole year and some change when it actually releases from when it got announced. And I tell you right now, if someone at E3 this year announces a game, just announce it and not show no gameplay, no nothing, not even a trailer. Just show, not even show you how it looks like a little bit. Just say a name, okay? And then a year and some change later, or at least a year, they finally show it off, and then some change, they actually show the thing. You'll be saying, why you didn't just wait until it was ready to show it off? That's what you'll say. And Scorpio is in that same category of, why did you talk about it when you didn't have nothing to show at E3 last year? The thing should have been revealed this E3, 2017. But anyway, the hype was real. The hype got high, and Microsoft dubbing it the strongest console ever made, you know, and then the guy, one of Microsoft's heads, one of Microsoft's people saying that developers don't have to, you know, let the Xbox One Original's frame rate hinder the fact that Scorpio is stronger. You can have different frame rates on the console than on the Xbox One S and Original. Like, my expectation got high even more, and 60 FPS started looking like it could do it. And Forza is rumored to be at 4K 60, and they say it will be at 4K 60. And not even rumored, it's been confirmed that that's what they're targeting. But at the end of the day, I don't want another PS4 Pro. See, PS4 Pro survives in my mindset because it has exclusives. It can play PS4's exclusives in the best way. PC can't play it. Xbox can't play PS4 exclusives in the best way. PS4 Pro is the only machine that can play PS4 exclusives in the best way. Scorpio don't have any Xbox exclusives. It has Microsoft exclusives, meaning it's on PC as well as on the Xbox, but it doesn't have any Xbox exclusives, only on it. So to play, let's say, Crackdown 3 in the best way, it'll be on PC. The best way to play State of Decay 2 will be on PC, if Scorpio doesn't do those games at 60 FPS. And I say, honestly, I tell you honestly, that I want Scorpio to be the best, because I don't want to go to PC. Look, I'm already putting down money to build me a PC. I'm already going to get my PC and get it ready so I can play all these games that I just mentioned at 60 FPS. I'm talking about all of Xbox games because it's all on PC too. But if Scorpio can show me, hey, you don't need to go PC, we got you. 60 FPS mode on State of Decay, 60 FPS mode on Crackdown 3. You know, like I said, if Scorpio does not give me a higher frame rate mode on their games, their own games, I don't even mind if third-party developers don't give me a high frame rate mode. But if they do it on their games, then that'll give me hope I will get a Scorpio, Project Scorpio. But if they don't, this E3 is making a breaker for me personally, because if they don't, if this, hey, it's native 4K, but it's 30 FPS, then I'm going to say no 1080p 60 mode, no 900p 60 mode, shucks. I will even take for a 720p 60 mode. No 60 frames per second mode? And they say no. I'm going to go full on PC for Xbox games, because you could play it on PC. Xbox is irrelevant if you don't have no exclusives to run on it, and also if your own games don't run at higher frame rates in comparison to getting on a PC. Like I said, I'll still have my PS4 because guess what? It has games that's only on it. And one day, if I ever get a Nintendo console, whatever it may be, whenever it may be, that only has games that you can only play on it, right? So Xbox Scorpio, if it only runs its games at 4K, because it's going to do 4K. Look, Microsoft will be liars if their games are not in native 4K, like they said. Phil Spencer said that. But if you don't have a high frame rate mode for your own games, because look, I'm already looking towards PC for Destiny 2 at 60 FPS. But I will look over there for Xbox games at 60 FPS if Scorpio can't deliver. But write in the comment section. I don't want to make this video too long. Because, yeah, you know what I mean? It started off asking the question, is PS4 Pro a failure? It's not. Quite frankly, it is. It isn't. It isn't. Because Sony literally told us what the thing was going to do. And like I said, I concluded that it was in that video, but I went ahead and looked at the whole conference again and concluded that PS4 Pro isn't. It is exactly what Sony said it'll be. But write in the comment section, I would love to hear your thoughts. What is your expectation for Scorpio, as well as what do you think? Do you think PS4 Pro is a failure? Please rate the video. Hashtag like, hashtag dislike. Put some feedback in the comment section below so I can get better to give you better content. Thank you. Also, please consider subscribing here for more gaming news from console to PC and maybe even tablets and phones. But that's all she wrote. This has been Raw, coming at you raw. Pieces. Now check it, I'm gonna just do a quick video. I wanna talk about Sony E3. Sony's E3 is, to be honest, no one's hyping Sony's E3 up because no one knows what Sony's gonna do. They literally screamed out everything they had last year. We got games to look forward to up until 2020. From last year, they showed us all this. What are they gonna show this year? Are they gonna show?